Thanks to Babbel for sponsoring this episode. Click the link in the description to start learning a new language today with Babbel. If you sign up for a 3-month subscription, you'll get an additional 3 months for free. How many times has this happened to you? Your phone buzzes, you grab it and unlock the screen, but there's no notification in sight. You've experienced a phantom phone vibration, or what some experts call phantom vibration syndrome. The good news is it's super common and not harmful on its own. But how often you experience these phantom buzzes may hold clues about your mental health in general. Results differ from study to study, but researchers are pretty sure phantom vibrations affect a lot of people. Phantom ringing is also a thing, but not all studies look at both at the same time. So we're going to focus on the buzzing. In one of the earliest studies of the subject in 2010, they found that around 68% of participants experienced some kind of phantom buzz. This was before most people carried smartphones in their pocket, so the researchers studied medical staff who always carried phones or pagers on vibrate mode. In the years since then, researchers have found some factors that make you more or less likely to feel the vibrations in the first place, like a younger age, keeping your phone on vibrate, and keeping it in a breast pocket. But these mystery vibrations themselves don't seem to be doing any harm. They're more of a quirk of our normal senses. Phantom phone vibes are likely a false alarm in something called our signal detection system, which is exactly what it sounds like. Our brains receive some sort of vague stimulus, like a light touch or dull noise, and make a decision about what it means. In the case of phantom phone vibrations, our brain has interpreted some other stimulus as a notification. That stimulus could be a familiar noise or a commonplace muscle twitch that kinda sorta maybe feels or sounds like a vibration. Plus, we expect to get notifications, and that makes our brains more likely to interpret other stimuli, or even a lack thereof, as a phone vibration. Getting false alarms from our signal detection system isn't necessarily a bad thing, but researchers have wondered if conditions like anxiety or depression might predispose us to experience false vibes more often. One 2013 study followed 74 medical interns over the course of a year-long internship and measured how often they felt phantom buzzes, as well as any symptoms of anxiety and depression. The researchers expected the interns would feel more phantom vibrations as their stress and anxiety increased. But in the end, phantom vibes happened totally independently of the participants' anxiety. On the other hand, a different study in 2014 looked specifically at tech employees and found that phantom vibes were associated with job stress and burnout. So there's no clear answer yet, but if you notice yourself checking on a blank screen more often, ask yourself if you've been feeling stressed lately. If you want to get more out of your phone than checking a blank screen, you might enjoy learning a new language with Babbel. Learning a new language requires a lot of time and commitment, making it tough to jump into conversations right away. Babbel aims to help you use a new language in real-life situations after only 5 hours of practice. Its lessons will teach you vocabulary and grammar skills that you can use in practical situations, like asking for directions or ordering at a restaurant. And these courses are designed by experts to take into account your native language, the one you'll be learning in. They offer 14 languages to choose from, including French, German, and Brazilian Portuguese. Babbel is offering SciShow viewers an additional 3 months for free if you sign up for a 3-month subscription today. We'll include a link in the video description so you can check out Babbel for yourself.